on the Medical Watch. Now, inverse vaccines.
Our medical reporter, Dina Baer, gives us a dose of education about how they work.
They're opposite of the vaccines we've come to know. Instead of giving a shot to rev up the immune system, these vaccines give orders to stop the immune response to certain cells. Local doctors believe with the inverse vaccine, they may have found the key to disabling some of the most debilitating autoimmune diseases.
A regular vaccine revs up immunity to fight an invader, but a regulatory vaccine, an inverse vaccine, revs up regulatory mechanisms to protect your own cells.
Think of it as the opposite of a typical vaccine. Researchers at the University of Chicago's Pritzker School of Molecular Engineering have figured out a way to tell the immune system which cells in the body to leave alone. In other words, marking healthy cells otherwise destroyed by multiple sclerosis, type 1 diabetes, or celiac disease.
These diseases like autoimmunity and allergy are usually treated by broad immune suppression, which has its downsides. It would be fantastic to develop an approach that could do it in a very specific way so you leave the rest of immunity intact.
The inverse vaccine works like other vaccines by delivering a message to T and B cells, the cells that help us fight infections, bacteria, and viruses. But instead of telling the cells what to attack, the inverse vaccine tells them what not to destroy.
There was quite a bit of unknown bits and pieces about the immunobiology there. So we came to understand that and then demonstrated in preclinical models that we could do things like treat autoimmunity, like treat multiple sclerosis in preclinical models.
Here's how the vaccine works. A nanomolecule loaded with cell material meant to be tolerated by the body is sent to the liver. The liver is where T and B cells are schooled on what to attack and what not to attack.
In the liver, that message is interpreted by so-called antigen-presenting cells, presented to T and B cells, that then turns on these regulatory effects.
In their lab, Dr. Jeffrey Hubble and his colleagues simulated a multiple sclerosis-like disease. The inverse vaccine stopped the immune system in mouse models from destroying myelin sheath on nerve cells. Even more promising, the formula appears to work even after damage has begun.
Not today, not tomorrow, but after a full series of clinical trials, we hope to be able to have treatments that are sort of one every, 6 months, every year, that could undo your immunity to that one particular disease, but leave the rest of your immunity intact.
The inverse vaccine has already been tested in clinical trials for celiac disease. Trials in multiple sclerosis patients are underway. Back to you.